So you've tested and you've received your results. And now as you're going through and looking at your results, you're seeing something like a first to second cousin or a second to fourth cousin. Well, what does this mean? How can somebody be a second to fourth cousin? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell if you want to receive notifications about new episodes. We have thousands of cousins. Actually, we have billions of cousins because we're all cousins. The only problem is almost all of these cousins are really distantly related to us. But even when we're talking about close relatives, everyone usually has several hundred fourth cousins or closer that they're related to. When reporting DNA relationships, the companies don't know what that relationship between two people is. Now, there's some relationships that are really easy to pinpoint. For example, a parent-child relationship. They share half of their DNA exactly. And that's really easy to see when we're looking at DNA. Siblings is another one that is very apparent as far as the amount of shared DNA that you have. But beyond that, relationships can be grouped into categories of common amounts of shared DNA. Now, because these different groups don't share exact amounts of DNA, but rather DNA along a range of values, it can make determining that relationship a little bit tricky. Now, because of this, some relationships actually look like other relationships, and the more distant that relationship is, the more potential relationships it could be. Now, in order to determine relationships, companies are looking at both the amount of shared DNA as well as the number of segments of shared DNA. In general, higher numbers of both of them indicate a closer relationship. But there is still a range of relationships that any combination could be because of the amount of overlap between these groups. For instance, second cousins share between 84 centimorgans and 484 centimorgans. And this could be over a range of 10 segments to as many as 35 segments. Now, third cousins share between 0 centimorgans and 174 centimorgans. And this could be between 0 segments and 15 segments. So you can see that between second cousins and third cousins, there's a range that overlaps that could be either second cousins or third cousins. When you get into half relationships and the number of generations removed, there tends to be a lot more overlap into all of these different relationships. So initially, the company is going to report the relationship as a range of possibilities, like second to fourth cousins, and then it's up to you to figure out how you're really related. On a pedigree chart, second cousins share great-grandparents. Now, everyone has four sets of great-grandparents. So if you have a match with a potential second cousin, it should be fairly easy between your four great-grandparents and their four great-grandparents to figure out which ones are the likely match. If you happen to have a third person who is also a second cousin, that makes this narrowing down even easier because all three of you have to be related to the same set of great-grandparents. Third cousins share second great-grandparents. Now, we have eight sets of second great-grandparents, and this is a little more tricky to narrow down with just two people, but if you have three or four third cousins together, all of them have to share the same great-great-grandparents, and that makes narrowing down who the potential great-great-grandparents are a lot easier. Let's look at this another way by using a relationship calculator. If we put in the amount of shared DNA we would expect to see on the low end of the second cousin level, we're going to say 90 centimorgans, you can see that the potential range of relationships actually covers second, third, and fourth cousins, but it also covers up to your third great grandparent and down to your first cousin three times removed. So there is a big amount of overlap in these relationships that potentially what looks like a second or third cousin could be. And this is why you should focus on the people who you are most closely related to genetically when you're starting your search. If you have unknown relatives that share at least 100 centimorgans or more with you, there's a good chance that you may be able to figure out how you are related when you're just starting out in genetic genealogy. For matches that are 30 centimorgans or less, it is very difficult to identify a common ancestor without a lot of other corroborating matches. So focus on finding your second to fourth cousins, and you may find that you have a bigger family reunion. If you have any questions about second to fourth cousins, put them in the comments below, and I'll try to answer them. And be sure to give us a thumbs up and share this video with your friends if you enjoyed it.